actor out of write your novel in 9 weeks. Today, I will be discussing and Bill will be interrupting with a few not necessarily helpful comments on you are what you read, sort of. There are 47 distinct genres within the novel category. Alright, I just made that up. Certainly somewhere came up with a list. Dissertation. But it's not of much use here. That's a polite way of saying it doesn't matter. Unless your novel is somehow about all the distinct genres within the novel category. And I suspect it's not. When you were younger and your mother let you use the good, meaning sharp, pair of scissors, she always warned you, don't cut yourself. Today's advice is almost that obvious.
Just as it's easier to write what you know, it's easier to write what you read. Mystery, fantasy, historical, young adult, middle grade, it makes no difference what you like.
Some people like tea over mead. Imagine.
Some people like coffee more than tea.
This is barbaric.
If you love science fiction and you've read a ton of it, it will be easiest for you to write science fiction. Probably. You know the ins and outs of that subgenre. You know the unwritten rules and the unspoken laws. Say, for example, you're writing a murder mystery, and you don't introduce the killer or offer any clues pointing to the killer until the final chapter.
Well, bad form, that. As the lovely Miss Agatha Christie would say, well, I'm sure she says something about, I don't have it on the tip of my tongue. Oh, but that, she wrote mysteries, you know.
Yes.
She was British.
Yes. At the same time, it's hard not to compare your current work to some of your favorite writers who have been penning their wonderful novels for years and years. Be of good cheer. They didn't start out as great writers.
Be of good cheer? Oh, my. You are trying to learn English, aren't you? It's very impressive. It's not actually good, but it is impressive. The attempt. The attempt is something.
Those writers got to the point at which you met them by doing what you've been doing over the past 2 weeks and what you will continue to do over the next 7 weeks. Furthermore...
Oh, please let me take this. Furthermore, pennies to pounds. See, you couldn't read that, Bill. You couldn't say that. Pennies to pounds. That wouldn't make any sense. You have to say dimes to dollars. Dimes to donuts. I don't know what you'd say, but you can't say pennies to pounds. Pennies to pounds, they looked at their self-imposed daily writing assignment, and they reacted just as you do with yours. Ugh. See that? You're already developing a professional attitude. And like them, you're climbing over that ugh, and completing that daily assignment.
Odds are your writing will sound a bit like theirs, and that's all right. Part of learning to write a novel is imitating novelists you like, the ones who have influenced you. After all, if you think what they did was good and you want to be good, why wouldn't you emulate their style?
Emulate? Listen to you. As Bill mentioned yesterday, over time, as you churn out thousands and thousands of words, their style will fade and your style will emerge. You may always write like so-and-so, but your voice will be distinctly present and obvious.
Finishing week two, aren't you? By the end of today's writing, you'll have more than 4,000 words on paper. Well done. Enjoy your day off tomorrow and return on week three, day one, ready to complete 500 words per day. You can do it.
You can. You really can.